Hi everyone, my name is Michaela Michelle. If you're new here and if not, then welcome back to my channel. Over on my little part of the internet, I make content on everything from fashion, beauty, hair, weight loss, food, fitness, and lifestyle. Yeah, I think that's it. So if you're interested in any of that, then be sure to check out my other content and to subscribe to my channel. But you guys, in today's video, I'm actually going to be talking to you about some of the tips and tricks that I use and that you can use to overcome overeating and to finally lose some weight, okay? So let's get on into the video. Now, before I get on into my list, I would like to give a quick shout out to our sponsor for today's video, and that is Bellway. Bellway was kind enough to send me some of their fiber supplement, and I've actually been trying them out for some time now before. If you did not know, fiber is a natural appetite suppressant. So if you are trying to eat less naturally without, you know, making yourself feel like you're hungry all the time, then fiber can help you with that. Also, it has been shown to help clear skin, improve nails and hair. So if you guys would like to give them a try, then be sure to use my code in my description box. It is Michaela25 for 25% off. Alrighty guys, so the first tip that I have was actually a major game changer for me and what actually really helped me finally get control and lose weight, and that is to identify your trigger foods and to remove them from your diet. So what I mean by trigger foods is simply a food that, you know, you really have a hard time controlling yourself around, you really have a hard time telling yourself no to, you have a hard time just eating a serving size of, okay? So for example, a trigger food might be chips, it might be cookies, candies, bread, pancakes, whatever it is. If it is something that you know you cannot control your impulses for, you cannot control your cravings for, then you need to simply remove it from your diet, remove it from even your out of sight, out of mind, if you can't. I know that's not always possible if you live in a household with other people. However, if you can, remove it from your diet completely. Now, when I say remove it from your diet completely, I do not mean forever, depending on the food. However, you need to remove it for some time so that way you can kind of gain control over your cravings, gain control over your impulses again, and then you can reintroduce the food slowly in a way that you know that you have control. And you almost need to, and I kind of said this in my weight loss video, but you almost need to kind of be a parent to yourself and watch yourself. So for example, if a trigger food for you is pasta and you say, okay, I'm gonna allow myself to have pasta one day a week, alrighty, on whatever day that is, you find yourself still eating gobs and gobs and gobs of pasta after you've taken a break from the food and reintroduce it, then it might be like, okay, I actually can't eat pasta one day a week. I need to move it to one day a month. I allow myself to have pasta. So that way, if you have pasta one day a month and you overeat on it, it's not gonna completely throw off your weight loss plan, if that makes sense. And you also, because you're spending so much time with not eating the food, it might actually help you learn to control your impulses a little bit more. Now, I really don't recommend completely removing certain foods. You kind of have to play it by ear because I don't want to cause you to binge on them. However, you, like I said, you have to be your own parent. You have to kind of learn what works best for you and try different things. And it's okay if you mess up. It's okay if you slip up, because guess what? You are learning yourself. You are learning how to help yourself be better. Alrighty, so now tip number two that I have kind of spawns off of that, and that is actually figuring out what times of day you have more cravings and lower impulse control. Now, for me, that's the evening, just because, you know, it's been a long day. I've dealt with everything, dealt with all my stress of the day. Now it's time for nighttime, and girl, I want a snack. I want to eat some cookies, some cakes, some chips, whatever. But however, that might not be the same for you. It might just simply be like a stressful time of day, like lunch at work, because you're at work and they've been stressing you out all day. Now you're like, girl, I'm sitting down and I want to have a Wendy's burger for lunch instead of having the sandwich that I packed. So what you want to do is basically, even though I'm not telling you to go ahead and binge during those times or overeat during those times, what you want to do is save your more calorically dense meals for those times, so that way you can kind of like balance out for the times when you're not having those cravings, not having those low impulse control, and you can kind of control yourself more during those other times. And then during the time when you know you struggle, you can kind of baby yourself a little bit, give yourself some leeway, some room to kind of improve and grow and get better without kind of ruining your entire calories for the day. Okay, so moving on to tip number three, that is to find better ways to make your favorite meals less calories and more nutritious. It could be done in several different ways, by simply, one, substituting ingredients, taking out ingredients, adding in ingredients. So I'm going to go through those three different ways with you guys. So firstly, taking out ingredients. So an easy way to save calories is simply by removing condiments, sauces, dressings, and cheese, okay? Those little suckers, those four little suckers will sneak up on your meal and add like 100, 200 calories for a meal that you're like, girl, I thought this was only 500 calories, but now it's 700 calories because you've been dumped a whole bag of honey mustard on your chicken. No, okay? So figure out what those high calorie things are, and if there's something that you can substitute out, take out completely, or just have less of, then it will make your meals less calories and reduce the amount that you are overeating by. Alrighty guys, so now the second thing that you can do is by adding more vegetables and lower calorie items into your meals to kind of make them a little bit more dense in the lower calorie things and less in the higher calorie things. So for an example of this is I love of a pasta. So something that I might do is add more spinach or add more vegetables to whatever pasta dish that I'm eating. So that way I'm getting full on those other vegetables and those other things, so that way I'm not overeating on it. Another thing I can do is take zucchini noodles and simply replace the pasta with the zucchini noodles. Now, I will say to you guys, zucchini noodles do not taste, or zucchini pasta, whatever you want to call it, does not taste like pasta, okay? It is not the exact same thing. Yes, sometimes I completely replace my pasta with zucchini pasta because, like, I don't know, I'm not craving pasta as much. I'm cool with, like, saving my calories and just I want a taste of some marinara pasta, you know, whatever. However, sometimes instead of just completely replacing the pasta with the zucchini, I will also zucchini pasta into my regular pasta, so that way, like, I'm having like half zucchini pasta, half pasta. It's less calories, still having the taste of pasta, still getting more vegetables. We're both living in a happy little world where Michaela gets what she wants. So it's just little things like that, little tricks like that that you can do to kind of help improve the nutrition of your meals and eat less of the higher calorie foods. All right, you guys, now last but not least, my favorite tip of all and one of the most effective is if you are an emotional eater, a boredom eater, someone with really low impulse control when it comes to food, then I suggest you plan ahead. And what I mean by that is you need to create two lists. One list of things that you are going to do instead of eating, and then a second list of kind of like things you have to do in order to have whatever it is that you're trying to have. Almost like kind of like a punishment or consequence. I don't want to call it punishment, but like almost like a consequence, or like you have to do this first list. So when I'm speaking, okay, so first off, let me talk about the distraction do instead of eating list. Now this list is not do instead of eating in the sense of like don't eat. No, I mean this in a sense of if you're, you know, you've ate all your meals for the day, you're sitting down, you get a really stressful text from your friend, now you're stressed out and you're like, ooh, I should go eat a bag of fruit snacks right now. But you know that's gonna turn into three bags of fruit snacks. Okay, so when it comes to emotional eating, I honestly have like a whole thought process that I kind of go through with myself when I find myself in that situation. However, that is for a different video. If you guys want me to make one, I'll make one. But this is a list that I kind of turn to when I'm like, okay, I need to do something other than eat that will make me happy, relieve whatever emotion that I'm feeling that I don't want to feel right now. That list needs to be frictionless tasks or frictionless activities that actually kind of bring you joy, make you happy, or, you know, will distract you from whatever it is that you're struggling with. So for example, it could be listen to five new songs or five songs from your favorite artist, five of your favorite songs, whatever. It might be watch one episode of your new TV show that you really, really love. Or it might be you get to do your nails, you get to window shop. Girl, let me tell you something. I'm just off the window shop thing because I actually didn't have this written down. Window shop just came to me. However, if you are like me, window shopping might be a little dangerous for you because I don't window shop. I just purchase, okay? So maybe don't do that one. But it just might needs to be a task that you find to be joyous, something that's going to like literally take your mind off of whatever it is that has you wanting to emotionally eat. Other things you can do is like go on social media sites. I love going on TikTok and Pinterest. I can literally scroll through them, forget where I'm at. I start daydreaming. I start laughing. I start, you know, whatever. So I recommend you making this list and putting it somewhere where like it's a go-to, okay? And also remember some of the things on the list in case you don't have the list with you. If you need, put it on your phone if you need to, hang it up in your room if you need to, whatever you need to do, but make that list and have it available for you so that way you don't have to be thinking about, okay, well, what can I do instead of thinking about my boyfriend not texting me back. No, you already know what you should be doing. So as soon as you have that feeling, or as soon as you have the feeling of like, oh, I want to go eat a bag of chips right now, recognize, okay, I'm only doing this because I'm emotional and I'm going to do this instead. All right, Now, moving on to the second list that you are going to have, because sometimes you are not going to have the impulse control and you are not going to make the decision to do something else. Let's just be honest, you are not going to always make the decision to not eat, okay? Especially when you are just starting out. So what you need to basically do is create a list of like almost like consequences or things you have to do in order to eat whatever it is you're trying to eat. So for example, like I said, if you are sitting here and you're like, oh, I really, really want a cookie right now. You know you don't need a cookie. You know you've kind of already ate your calories for the day. You shouldn't eat that cookie. What you're going to do is have a list of things that you have to then do before you allow yourself to eat the cookie. That might be workouts, like, okay, I got to do 5 sit-ups, 10 jumping jacks, 15 burpees. Make it something that you don't want to do, okay, but something that you will do. A list of workouts, you can be cleaning things. So like, oh, okay, if I want to eat this cookie, I have to go clean up my bathroom. I have to go do a load of laundry. I have to go fold these clothes, something like that. I have to go do some dishes before I can eat the cookie. Or it could even be schoolwork or just regular work that you have to get done. And that way, at least you are kind of improving other aspects of your life while you're also eating that cookie, or at least that's my thought process. And a lot of the times, if you get to this list, make it things that like you really don't want to do, because I'll be like, girl, I do not feel like doing 2 minutes of jumping rope right now. So therefore, I will not be eating a cookie. It's not worth it. But you have to make sure you have the discipline to stick to that, okay? Like, you can't say that and then be like, oh, I'm just gonna eat the cookie anyway. No, you have to have some level of discipline to just kind of stick to this list. Okay, alrighty, so that was the last of my tips, but I just wanna say that nothing that I said is going to be without effort, is not going to be without discipline. Everything you do when it comes to weight loss, is you are going to have to put your effort in, and that's okay. This is going to be a beautiful journey for you if you allow it to be. And I know you're probably like, girl, shut up, no one wants to hear that. But trust me, as someone, I'm not even done with my journey yet, I'm kind of like more on a fitness journey now, but as someone who's like lost so much weight, I just look back at myself and I'm like so proud of myself, and I want that for you too. So please, even if your goal isn't just to lose weight, but you just realize that you're overeating on unhealthy food, it's so amazing to get to a point where you're like, I have control, I have self-discipline. And I'm not claiming that you're going to have it all the time, because you're not. No one is perfect. But exercising some of these tips is just going to better help you kind of get to that other side where you have better coping mechanisms, better skills, and better eating patterns. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please be sure to like, comment, subscribe, turn on my post notifications, check out my other content, and follow me on Instagram @MikaelaMichelle. Bye.